In this video, I'm going to show you how to tailor the OpenAI's DaVinci model responses for your chatbot. So let's get started. So the most important thing about this entire process is the data that we're going to be providing. So to start off with, I'm going to create a folder called data. And inside here, I'm going to create a JSON-L file, which is a JSON lines file. So I'm going to call it data.json-L. And I'm going to copy some data in here that I've pre-written. So this is laid out, so I say JSON-L, we have a prompt, and our prompt is the question that's going to be asked, and then our completion, which will be the answer that's provided. I've got 27 in here. I want to keep it short and the training time short. You can put as many in here as you want. The more you put in, the more expensive it will be to run. This 27 questions cost about 13 pence, but I'm on the free mode at the moment, which I have $18 to spend because it's within the first 3 months. So if we save that, next thing we want to do is initialize the node project. So we're going to run npm init inside the terminal. And I'm just going to enter through all of these. It's not that important. We're not pushing it anywhere. And that should create a package.json file. So the only package we'll need to install for this is OpenAI. But I will also be installing .env just so I can store my API key securely. I'm also going to copy over an environment file which contains my API key. From here, we're just going to create an index.js file. And I'm going to run through this step by step. So we'll upload the file, we'll fine-tune the model, and then what we'd see, we get the process of the fine-tuning to see what level we're at the time. And then we get a list of the fine-tuned models that we currently have, and then we'll test our model. So I'm going to paste in the imports here and discuss what's got happening here. So I've got the .env, which is allowing me to access the process environment file, and that's where the API key is stored. I'm also importing the configuration in the OpenAI API from OpenAI. Then I'm importing this configuration into this new OpenAI API here and giving that a constant value in OpenAI. I'm also importing FS, I'll explain why later. So let's talk about how we actually access this API key, how we obtain an API key. So inside of our openai.com account page here, we have our list of our API keys. What we can do is create a new secret key, and then we can import that into our environment file. So once we've got that, what we want to do is we want to create a new constant. I'm going to call this prepare data. That's going to be equal to OpenAI and dot create file. Now this is where we need to use the fs create read stream, because here it says we can just import a file, but we actually need to stream a file across. So we do fs.create read stream, and then inside here we want data slash data.json-l. And then our second part here are options, fine tune. And that will tell OpenAI exactly what we want to do with this file. So I'm just going to add a dot and a slash before that, just so we're working in this directory. So this is going to return a promise for us, so we can prepare the data and then dot then, and this will return the data that we need. We won't actually be using any of that data, so we can just console log this out. And this will give us our file name. We'll do a catch here as well, just in case there is an error. We can capture the error that's happening. So if we save this and now run, that's my bad. We need this fine tune outside of this create read stream here. So with that outside, if we rerun this, there we go. So it's returned us our data here with our file name. We'll keep that saved away. So let's create a new constant up here. We'll call that file name. And we can see that that's uploaded and the size. So the maximum size you can actually upload to this is 1 gigabyte. As I say, the more content you upload, the more expensive it will be to run. So now that we've uploaded the file and we've got our file name, we can delete this section here. And what we can do is we can now create a new constant. And this will be called response, and this will be OpenAI. And we want to have create Finetune. I'm going to pass an object inside of here with a model. And we're going to be using the DaVinci model. And we also want to pass a training file. And that training file is this file name here. So response will also pass back a promise. So we can console log the information out from there. And we also catch it just in case there is an error. So if we save this and we run now, this is what's actually going to create our Finetune model on the OpenAI server. So if we run this again, so we can currently see that it's pending. So we can now create another bit of script that will tell us the progress of what the Finetune's doing. So we'll keep the file name up here. I'm not too sure we'll need it again. I don't think we will, but we'll keep it just in case. So I'm going to create a new constant called models. That's going to be equal to openai.listFinetune. So list Finetune events. And if we go to what we console logged out beforehand, we should have an ID in here. So this data ID, and this is what we want to pass inside of here. This will tell us the progress, the events that are linked to this ID here. And you can also stream this data. So this next stream here is a Boolean, and you can stream the data, so you don't have to keep passing this information. For some reason, it doesn't work for me. So if we run models, then data. And I click save, and I click run. This normally errors out for me. There we go, there's the error that it passes back for me. For some reason I can't get the streaming to work. So what we're going to do, we're going to set the streaming to false. And then I'm going to wrap this inside of a set interval. And that set interval will run every 30 seconds. For this example, we'll run every 10 seconds. And then I'll click run again. And then in a second, we should get a response. So I'm going to rechange this down to 5 seconds. And we're going to console log out data.data.data, come out of this, run this again, and we should now get a list of the actual events that are happening here. So currently all it says is that we created a Finetune event. This will come back with more information later on. For the sake of this tutorial, I did run one earlier. So what I'll do is I'll grab that file name and I'll pass that into here. Not the file name, the Finetune ID. I'll paste that into here, click save, I'll come out of this, and then I'll rerun this, and you can see exactly what we get as a response. So that should be coming up any second now. Here we go. So I'll just cancel out of that. You can see it's quite a long response. So this is where our last one was, created Finetune, and then it will tell us that the Finetune is going to cost X amount of dollars, or cents in this case, and then it will start to tell us that it's enqueued. So this whole process from uploading through to actually getting this through the queue and then running through the epochs and then telling me which the uploaded model name is, that whole process took about 4 hours to complete. So the file I actually used for this was exactly the same data JSON-L file we have here. So we can still do the testing as if we've just uploaded that file. If you ever need to actually just get a list of your models, what we can do is we can run a const models. That would be equal to openai.listFinetunes. That will return a promise. You can click save and we can run this file again. And we can see it's under data, data. So we console log out data.data.data. Click save, rerun. And this will give us a list of our current models. So here's the one that I created earlier, status succeeded. We have our fine-tuned model name here, which we will copy and we'll paste in as a new variable up here. So const model equals DaVinci FT Web Nexus 2023-02-23180338. We can see that this one is still pending. So now that we've got the actual model name, we can start testing the model. What we do is create a const, and that's going to be called response. And that will be equal to OpenAI.createCompletion. And this will take in a model, and that model will be the same as the model we have here. So we can get rid of that there. And then we create a prompt. So as a test, what I'm going to do is copy one of these questions from here, copy it in and paste it into here, click save, and then what we'll do, we get the response.then, so this returns a promise, it returns data here, we console got data.data.choices, we get the first available choice, and then we want to get the text of that. So if we click save, and then we run again. So this has provided a bit of an ambiguous output. I'm sure that if you're uploading factual information with real values in, it will return the actual new real values that you've provided. The more information you pass through in here, so 27 props is nowhere near enough to retrain this model on. If you were going to do this, you could be talking about hundreds or thousands of lines here that you'd need to upload. And this is a great way to have more factual information pushed up and a model that's more precise to your needs. If you want to cancel the model as well, just in case you've uploaded the wrong file or you've fine-tuned your content a bit more, what we can do is, if we remove this here, and we say openai.cancelFineTune. And then inside here we pass the model, which we have as model here. And then underneath we can do response.then and do the same as we have done before. It does return a promise. Click save, and then we can run this, and that will cancel the model for us. I've got an error here at the moment because the job is actually completed. And then let's say you wanted to delete a model. We can do OpenAI, and then we can also delete a model. And the same again, the response has returned as a promise. Click save, and we can run this. And we can see here that deletion of this model is true. So if you found this video useful, hit the subscribe button and the like button. Also, check out these two videos on screen now. First one is where I show you how to build this into an API, and the second one shows you how to build a front end in Angular. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.